Hello friends, today we will see how to use the simple CLI application in Weka. In previous video we have seen how to use the experimenter application and a knowledge flow application in Weka. So just to use the simple CLI, click on this tab and the user will be navigated to a new window. So this is basically a simple CLI mode of Weka, where the command line interface is available to the user for the different operations on the data set. Okay. So in simple CLI, there is a syntax used to write the command, that is Java space package name or a class name, followed by the arguments, and followed by arguments there will be a path of the input file for which we want to perform the classification. Well, here I will take a simple example. Java, my package name is, or my class name is Weka dot classifiers dot trees dot J48 classifier I am using from tree option. So it is a tree classifier which will build the classification model in the form of tree, which has the edges and the nodes. And I will press enter, and you can find that some error is being displayed on the simple CLI. What is the error? Error is the Weka exception. No training file and a no object input file is given. Apart from this, there are some general options that have been displayed on the screen. That is hyphen h for help, hyphen synopsis or hyphen info to output the synopsis for the classifier, hyphen small t to set the training file, to give the training file as an input to your classifier, hyphen capital T to set the test file, or you can provide the test file as an input to your classifier, and so on. Apart from this, there are some other options which are specific to this class, called as weka.classifier.trees.j48. Remember, here J48 is our classifier, and you can see there are different arguments we can use with this class, such as hyphen u to unprune the tree, hyphen o do not collapse the tree, hyphen c to prune the confidence, to set the confidence threshold for pruning purpose, hyphen m for the minimum number of instances. So whatever value that user will supply with this argument will be a minimum number of instances, otherwise the classifier won't process the dataset file. The user has to the classification model expects the minimum number of instances for classification purpose, and so on. Now if a user finds a difficulty to write the big command or a long command on the command line interface, in that case user can take a help of Explorer tab, where go to the Weka and click on Explorer. We know that how to use the Explorer application in Weka. So here I will go to the data set. So here is the data set. I'll select Iris as my data set, and we know that in classification tab the different classification methods are available. So what I will do, I will select a tree classification method called as J48, and when you click left to edit the properties of this object, there is an option called copy configuration to clipboard. So you can click here just to copy the classifiers, the class or the package, the Weka package for the J48, and just simply paste it here, Java package name, and here you can see that two arguments have been used along with this classification, that is hyphen c and hyphen m. We know for what purpose hyphen c is used. So hyphen c argument is used to set the confidence threshold for pruning purpose, whereas the threshold value supplied here is 0.25. the next argument used here is hyphen m, and we know that hyphen m argument, it defines the minimum number of instances. Right here, the value of this argument is 2, which indicates us that the J48 classification expecting minimum 2 instances to process. Well, now the next argument that we have to or is expected here is the input file. Now it depends on the user's choice what kind of file user want to give as the input to this classifier, whether user want to give the train data set or a test data set. If user wish to give the train data set, then hyphen small t argument is used, and if it is a test data set, then capital T letter will be used as an argument. So here I will give the input file as a train data set followed by the path of the file. So under data set folder, under data folder, these are the default data set that Weka provides. I want to select this iris as one of the train data set to this classifier J48. I have copied the path followed by the name of file, that is iris.arff. Remember here, .arff extension, it indicates the file format, and the file format that Weka supports is attribute relation file format, where the file has two types, whether its data set is nominal or it would be a numeric. And the file has the three different section which contains the relation, the file attributes and the data. So when we look after how to split the given data set into a train data set and a test data set, in that video I will explain you all these details of ARFF file. For the time being, just remember that we have selected this file iris.arff as the input to this classifier J48. So when you press enter, yes, the classifier is run, and the result is shown on the command line interface. That is, the options or the arguments that we have used along with this classifier is -c, which is just to set the confidence threshold value for the tree, and here the threshold value is 0.25, whereas -m is the minimum instances, and the minimum instances that classifier expecting here is 2. Then J48 prune tree, these are the attributes, or you can say the features of the data set: petal width, petal length, and sepal length, sepal width. So these are some features of the data set. The number of leaves that this J48 prune tree has is 5, and the size of the tree is 9. The time taken to build the model is 0.02 seconds, whereas time taken to test the model on the training data set is 0 second. Now, this result is followed by the statistics of the error on the train data set. So the statistics shows that out of 150 instances, 147 instances have been correctly classified by the classifier. Thus, the accuracy of model is 98%, whereas 3 instances have been misclassified by the classifier. Thus, the error rate of classifier is 2%. And these are some kappa statistics related to the classifier, such as relative absolute error, relative mean square error, mean absolute error, and so on. This is the details of confusion matrix. Remember, we have studied that the performance of classifier is evaluated by using various parameters. So confusion matrix is the one way to assess the performance of the classifier. The fields or the parameters of confusion matrix are nothing but true positive ratio, true negative ratio, false positive ratio, false negative ratio, precision, accuracy, error, and so on. Right. So here you can see the confusion matrix, where the first row, the rows indicate the instances of corresponding to the class, whereas column indicates the correct classification of classifier for the given input instance. So this first row, first column entry 50 indicates that there are total 50 setosa instances, and all these instances have been correctly classified by the classifier. The second entry, that is second row and second column entry 49, indicates that 50 instances of versicolor class, out of this 50 instances, 49 instances are correctly classified, whereas this second row third column entry, this indicates that this instances actually belong to versicolor, but it have been misclassified as virginica instance by the classifier. And similarly, in the third row, these two instances actually belongs to virginica class, but they have been misclassified as versicolor instances by the classifier. Whereas this third row third entry, this indicates that the 48 instances have been correctly classified by the classifier. So here it is important to know that, here it is important to interpret this confusion matrix. The column of this confusion matrix, it indicates the correct and incorrect classification of instances by the classifier, whereas the horizontal or the rows of this confusion matrix, it indicates the total number of instances of each class. We have seen that what is the cross validation. So cross validation is nothing but the n validation fold of a given trained data set. And this is the statistics of the cross validation data set, where you can observe there are, out of 150 instances, 144 instances have been correctly classified by the classifier, and thus we can achieve the 96% accuracy in the model, whereas there is a misclassification of 6 instances, which results into 4% of error rate for the model. And same as, these are some the kappa statistics for the classifier. And this confusion matrix is belong to the cross validation data set. I hope you understood how to use the simple CLI. You can use the different classifier for in the same way as we have done it for the J48. I will show you one more classifier, Java. To import the package, you can choose the classifier. I can choose the classifier namebase, copy the package name, go to simple CLI interface, command line interface, just copy it, and just give the input file as the train data set. Copy the path of your train data set file, paste it here, iris.arff, and just press enter. There is unfortunately some error is being appeared. Okay, we have not given the train data file. See, this is the small error. I'll just correct it. And yes, so this is the result for namebase classifier. I hope you understand how to use the simple command line interface application in Weka. Thank you so much. In the next video, I will explore you how to use the experimenter application in Weka. Thank you. Thank you so much.